Hello Librans,
welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you from April 10th to April 20th. And as you know, they are all general readings. They may or may not resonate with each and every one of you. They may be your energies, energies of the person or the situation you are dealing with, or maybe the mix of both. So please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation. And if the reading does not resonate with you, please check your moon sign, Venus sign and the name sign. And if you want to get a personal reading, the details are given in the description box below. And yeah, you can subscribe to my channel while I'm laying down your cards. So Librans, let's see what's in store for you. Okay. Wow. We have the Wheel of Fortune. Hangman is coming in every reading today. Hangman. The Ten of Wands. Okay. Okay. Four of Swords. Nine of Swords. And the Ace of Wands, okay. Knight of Pentacles, the Judgment, and Seven of Pentacles, Magician. Let me see the messages from the other deck. What are the additional messages for Libras? What are the additional messages for Libras? Okay. There were three cards. I'll just wait for one card, okay? Though I have seen the messages. If it really has something to convey, it will again come out. Don't worry. Okay. Wow. Beautiful. So, what is the guidance from the angels for Librans from 10 to 12, 20th? Okay, Helper of Action. I've taken one more card just because I felt like doing so. Now let me see what is the inside card for Libras. Okay. So Librans, what's happening is we're starting with a very good card. With the Wheel of Fortune, which is immediately followed by the Hangman, and both of them are major arcana. So what I am feeling here is that things started moving forward, or they have started moving in the recent past. They started moving forward in your favor, and you are very happy with the changes which were happening. So, and you were getting the rewards of whatever you were doing, whatever efforts you were putting in, or you have put in. But things were changing in your favor. You were being rewarded, and you happy times were seeming to come towards you, or they had already started coming in. Something of that sort had started happening, and the Wheel of Fortune is a pretty good card. Things were started moving in your favor. But then suddenly, I'm being drawn to this snake out here, and this somebody is somebody was trying to pull you back, or not the word stab, but yes, you were carrying the things were moving forward very nicely, and then somebody was trying to, like a snake, they were trying to poison you from behind. I don't know, I'm getting drawn to this snake very much, and what I'm getting is, though this snake didn't reach you, but yes, there was that energy of a snake behind you, which you were not aware of. Somebody poisonous in your vicinity? I don't know. So, see, it can be, because now the things have stuck anyway. So it can be, things were started moving forward, things were pretty happy, and then suddenly, because of this hangman energy, things came to a halt. Nothing is moving forward. And then we have the Ten of Wands. Somebody is working very, very hard. Somebody is taking all the responsibilities all alone. So what I am getting is, maybe you've been poisoned by someone. Maybe somebody was doing something behind your back, which because of which the things came to a halt. And now you feel that you are carrying the entire burden. If it is a relationship, then you are very burdened. It is a burden now. Things have become a burden for you, whatever they, wherever they are. Now this snake won't be there for everyone. So Librans, just don't think that this snake-like energy is there for everyone. It can be for some of you. But yes, overall the Wheel of Fortune is a good energy. So maybe because of something, the things have come to a halt. At least that much is pretty sure, that things are on hold. Things are just not moving forward, and you are feeling burdened in this situation. You are not, because you know that your things are not moving forward. Maybe you are carrying the responsibility of the situation or the energy or the relationship on your own. And now, because here we have the, so definitely something bad has happened, because with the Four of Swords and with the Nine of Swords, you are spending sleepless nights. You are working very hard all alone. You are all alone working very hard, whosoever it is, this person is. And then with the Nine of Swords, the thing is that you are over anxious, spending sleepless nights, overthinking, and you have it, overanalyzing things, overthinking, the sleep is being compromised, your mental health is being compromised, and you are sort of in an energy of a anxiety or a depression type of a thing. You have that negativity. You are very, very upset with this situation, whatever this hanged man is, because of this hung up situation. You are very tense, that's what I'm getting. And then you, because you are not able to do anything about it, you just surrender to the situation, and there is a lot of healing. You try to heal yourself because of this Nine of Swords. You're trying to heal yourself, you've surrendered, you are praying, you are trying to recollect the positive memories of the past. Maybe with your loved ones, maybe with this person who's, if it is a relationship, maybe of your parents, whatever. But yes, definitely you are trying to go back to the past. You are trying to refresh those memories, live in those happy memories, so that you are able to come out of this negative situation, of this anxiety. You are just not fine. You've stopped working, sort of. You have put off this burden. You've decided to put off this burden. That's what I'm getting. With the Ten of Wands, you are working very, very hard towards something, so somebody has put off this burden, definitely. Maybe it can be that things started moving fast, things did start to change, but then suddenly they came to a halt, and the other person who was working very hard towards this is also now fed up with this, and this person leaves all the responsibilities, and they're just fed up, they give away this, decide to give up on this situation, and it is giving up on the situation, perhaps. And then you just try to lie low, okay, yeah, whatever will be, and you are trying to overcome this anxiety of yours, and this depression, and those sleepless nights. You're trying to comfort yourself, basically. And then we have the Ace of Wands. So definitely it is a passionate new beginning, or you are ready to, or somebody, or you yourself are ready to offer your love or your passion towards to someone, because suddenly it is being followed, all the sleepless nights, all that anxiety, you are surrendering it, and suddenly there is a new beginning out here. And with the Knight of Pentacles, there is love, there is opportunity, something is there, but it is very slow. No action is to be seen, though love is there. Nothing is moving forward. Maybe this is what was happening. Because again here we have the Judgment and we have the Seven of Pentacles. So what I am getting here is that now with the love is there, relationship is there, but things are just not moving forward. It is a standstill type of situation, and it is very irritating for the other person perhaps, or you. And then there is a Judgment. Now here you have to take a decision. It is a decision, either the universe will take it for you, or you take it for yourself, or you will be forced, or the circumstances will force you to take a decision. But yes, some decision is being called for, which is affecting the other person or many people around you, and this decision has to be taken in a yes or a no type of a thing. It is a decision time now. And with the Seven of Pentacles, maybe someone is wondering what to do. Somebody has built up, somebody has worked hard, somebody is making all the efforts, and then they are just wondering to make the next move. And with the magician, all the resources are there. It is again a new beginning. It is again when you have all the resources, you know you can move your wand in any direction and you can do whatever you want. So magic can be woven. You know you can do anything. A magician can do anything what they want. They can create magic, they can do whatever they want. Okay, so now since you have the resources, I think things are moving slow. Then you think of deciding. It is now you think, yeah, things were moving very slow. Then it's a time to decide. You have to take a decision, and you are just wondering as to what decision should I take. And then with the magician, you take some decision because you are called to make a decision. And then with the magician, there is a new beginning, and you are in a position of making a new beginning. Excuse me. And with the Seven of Diamonds over here, we have the Sun card. So again, it is happiness. So there is a lot of happiness over here. And the cards which flew out from the deck, three cards which flew out from this deck, and I kept them back. They were the Tower card, which was, again, there was a Queen, which was the Tower. That means there is some shake-up of events has happened in your life, though I didn't include them in the reading. I'm just telling you. So there was a Tower, which means that whatever this event has happened, there was a sudden shake-up in your life, maybe of a belief, maybe something really happened pretty fast in your life, which shaked up everything, and you were totally shaken up, and maybe that is the cause of this anxiety. And there was a Queen of in which you need to give time to yourself. It is all about spirituality, healing, meditation. And that is the message there in this card also, with the Four of Swords. And then there was a King of Spades, which was all about moderation. So you need to moderate, you need to weigh the pros and cons, you need to moderate. A lot of moderation is needed in this situation. Okay, so those were the three cards which came out. I'll take them out. Yeah. So these were the three cards which came out at that time. One was the Queen of Diamonds, which is all about healing. It is all about spirituality, be in touch with nature, give time to yourself to heal. Okay, meditate. This is what you are supposed to do because of this anxiety. And now the cause of this anxiety was the first card which came out was the Tower. The lightning has struck. It is something which has happened to you and which has sort of shaken up your foundations, and you were not expecting it. But the foundation in this deck, what I am getting is the foundation is still strong. It's not devastated. Things have not fallen down as in the Rider-Waite deck. In the other deck, the things have really fallen off. The Tower is still intact. Though things have happened, but the foundation which I am getting is foundation is still strong. Librans, don't worry, the foundation is still strong. Everything is not yet lost. That's what I am getting. Yes, some event has happened which has shook you, but not the Tower is still intact. The foundation is very solid. Still, it is very solid. Don't worry. And with the Queen over here, a lot of healing is there. And with the King of Hearts, we have the King and the Queen, though they are of a separate deck. One is Diamonds and one is the Heart, but still they are the King and the Queen. And moderation is needed. You need to moderate your emotions, you need to moderate your thoughts, you need to take a decision after weighing pros and cons. A lot of moderation is required in this situation. Number 19 or number 20 may be of some significance for you, even number 2. I forgot to read these two cards first. Yeah. Helper of action. You are blessed with many wonderful things to do. It would be great if you take the time to make a plan first, but you probably don't have the time. So get busy, follow your instincts and have fun. You or someone you meet is very self-assured, capable and enthusiastic and can do anything with a smile. So basically, maybe this opportunity, maybe this Knight of Pentacles, or maybe this new opportunity which is coming in your life or whatever, if you decide to offer this opportunity to someone or somebody comes in your life, whatever it is, so you have wonderful things which are coming in, and it would be great if you plan. If you're not able to plan because the judgment is coming, it's fine, it's okay, then still just do what needs to be done and just follow your instincts. Six of thought. Peaceful times are on the horizon. The storms have passed, and now that you can see that your destination is within sight, the stress in your life will begin to fade away. So the stress in your life will begin to fade away, allowing the happier times. It may be necessary to take a journey over water to another country. So basically, it can be somebody has to take a journey, or it can be a mental journey, an emotional journey, whatever. But yes, happier times are coming, and the Magician is there for a new beginning. Now, yeah, express love through gifts. A small token of love can convey great appreciation. So again, maybe some of you really need to travel here also. There is a lot of water. But yeah, the situation here demands expression of love. Now, this expression of love can be through communication, can be through a small token of some gift, can be quality time together, can be a smile, can be a conversation, can be a phone call, can be anything. But yeah, somebody needs to express love. Expression is needed, somebody needs to communicate, perhaps that's what I'm getting. Expression of love is definitely needed over here in this situation to move forward, that's what I feel. Let me see if there is anything else for the Libras. Yeah, with the Three of Cups, there is a celebration coming in. With the Page of Wands, yeah, you are ready to move forward. Hermit, yeah, follow your intuition. That has been told to you previously also. Be in touch with your insight, follow your intuition. Yeah, again the Moon. Yeah, follow your instinct. Whatever your instinct says, just do that. Wands, you are Five of Wands. You are conflicted over a situation. There has been a fight or an argument or a mental conflict. Definitely something is happening. Follow your intuition. Discuss with whosoever you need to. Empress is again a new beginning. Definitely a new beginning is happening in your life, Librans. You are moving away from the negativity and turbulence with the Six of Swords. Seven of Cups. Lot of confusion. Mental confusion is there. King of Cups. Dealing with someone who is very compassionate and in control of their emotions. And yeah, Queen of Pentacles. So yeah, definitely there are a lot of emotions. I think expression of love is needed in this situation. The King of Swords. Nine of Pentacles. You are upset over something. So yeah, same messages are coming again and again, Libran. So basically the thing is, yeah, that is what you need to do. Just follow your intuition, just follow your insight, and do whatever you feel your inner guidance has to say. Okay, there is no need of stressing over, because there are new beginnings, and the only thing is you need to communicate. I think you need to express in some way, shape or form. That's all. So okay, Libras, that's all I have for you, and please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.